Of our ongoing celebration of the Chicago Bears 100th season, we're looking at some of the stories and people behind the Bears.
In tonight's edition of The Lowdown, WGN's Mike Lowe introduces us to a key team member who makes the players look good without ever stepping on the field.
But it was something at Soldier Field.
This time of year,
the Bears have a game on Monday.
At most barber shops in Chicago, you'll likely find people talking about the Bears.
The Bears, man, it's been killing it.
In this shop, however, you're more likely to find them talking to the Bears. Lawrence Funk is the official barber of the Bears, and he handles the hair of everyone from the coach to the quarterback.
It's phenomenal.
It all happened by accident for a kid from Kenosha with a curious name.
People would crack jokes and, you know, not necessarily pick on me, but having the Funk as last name as a kid, I mean, it was brutal. But now, I mean, people get a kick out of it.
His mother was a beautician and had hair clippers and scissors around the house. So he started cutting his own hair. Then he started trimming his friends and family. Soon he attended barber school. And now he owns Funk's Barbershop, which he has decorated with hand-selected antiques.
I've collected individual items and then multiple items. There's a barbershop neon sign that I just recently picked that up, but that's a new add to the shop, and I'm constantly adding new things, moving things around, but it just keeps the eye wandering.
It was two guys wandering into his shop that changed his professional life forever.
I remember I was cutting here, I had this door open, and they walked in, and O'Donnell's like 6'5", so he's a big guy, and you know, they're both athletic, so I'm like, you know, okay, what's up, boys?
And someone recommended me to him, and me and a former teammate went in there, and the rest is history.
It was Bears punter Pat O'Donnell and backup quarterback David Fales. Funk had no idea who they were.
I've never been a fan of football.
But through casual conversation in the chair, he found out they were Chicago Bears.
And then he told me, I'm like, pretty cool.
He's a cool guy, down-to-earth guy. He listens to you. He talks anything but football if we want to, so it's cool to have a guy like that just to bounce ideas off of.
O'Donnell left the barber's chair like he just emerged from a Metropolis phone booth.
Clark Kent, I mean, he's probably got the fullest, blackest set of hair on the team, I think.
As soon as his teammates saw him, they wanted the same superhero look.
From there, it led to all special teams, to Jay Cutler, to Mitch, Zach. I mean, it's the list goes on, and it's all been word of mouth.
When Jay Cutler went from the lazy Bieber bangs to a stylish magazine cover boy, it was Funk's handiwork. Now he's getting a new Bears quarterback magazine ready.
Mitch Trubisky is one of my regulars. He says, look good, feel good, play good.
Former Bears tight end Zach Miller is another client.
Zach Miller was cutting in his own hair since high school, college, into the NFL. Never had a professional haircut. He goes in the bathroom, comes out, and he's like, listen, I'm not going to cut my hair ever again. I'm going to just have you cut it.
Miller's exaggerated gentleman's cut caught the eye of general manager Ryan Pace.
Zach called me and said, hey, do you mind if I send our GM to you? No problem.
Pace went from a gee whiz to a GQ. As his hair clipped off, a light bulb went on.
He said, hey man, you know, I'm thinking about doing a barbershop at Hallis Hall. Would you be interested in running it for us? 100%, I'm in. I cut a lot of you guys. It would be perfect.
So when the Bears completed a multi-million dollar expansion of Hallis Hall, the team added barber chairs and made him the first barber of the Bears.
Now he's cutting inside the Bears locker room, which is cool. He's like family now.
Now I'm their first in-house barber, yeah.
Now even the famously bald-headed head coach, Matt Nagy, goes to Funk for a shave and beard trim before every game.
I straight razor his entire head, I straight razor his beard, I line everything up and I take the length down, and that's a game ritual. He calls it the winning ritual.
A close shave for the coach and a big win for the barber, who certainly makes the cut. In downtown Chicago, Mike Lowe, WGN News.
Yeah, thinking about a fade maybe. I need to go with something.
You?
Yeah, no?
No.
Let's see what Mr. Funk will do.
All right. He's going to funk you right on up.